Hey, welcome back to another Motion edition of Apple a Day. Today's episode is part one of two, and we're going to work on recreating the title sequence in TV's Smallville. Here's a sample clip of the original titles from the TV show. Here's a clip showing you what we're going to accomplish in today's episode. For this project, I've supplied the necessary assets that you'll need to recreate it yourself. They're in a Dropbox link in the description below. So let's get started. I've already got a project open. I'm going to go to my Finder and drag over the smallville.psd file. This is a layered Photoshop file with each letter in its own layer. I'm going to select that. I'm going to drag it onto Motion. And if I hold it for a second, I get a drop-down menu that says Import Merge Layers, Import All Layers, or Choose Layer. What I want to do is import all of the layers, so I'm going to select that. And as you can see on my layers panel, it pulled in each layer and retained their original layer name. So I'm going to rename this group to Smallville, Back, and I'm going to scale this down because it's a little too big. That looks about right. I'm going to move it up a little. Right about there. So to achieve the light ray effect that comes off of the Smallville text, we're not going to use the light ray filter. I tried it with that, and the problem is it's limited to how far the rays can extend. So the next solution is to use the zoom blur. So if I were to apply the zoom blur to the entire Smallville text, what happens is the whole thing blurs, which looks cool. And even if I move the center position, you can see how it moves across. It's kind of neat, but that's not what happens in the show. What happens in the show, each letter has these light rays coming off of them one at a time. It's almost as if a light is passing behind the word Smallville and shining on one letter at a time, and each letter is extending the light rays. In order to achieve that, we have to apply this zoom blur to one letter at a time. So I'm going to remove it from there. And I'm going to go down to S, and I'm going to add the zoom blur. And I'm going to extend the amount, and you'll see we have a problem right away. And the problem is the blur is being cropped by the size of the letter. So the solution for this is to make the project 3D. So I'm going to add a camera, and it's going to ask me to switch to 3D. So I click on that, and that solves the problem. And you can see the zoom blur extending well beyond the bounds of the original size. So I'm going to go back to the zoom blur for the letter S, and I'm going to fill in the properties to what I determined ahead of time. The amount should be set to 60. And now we need to move the X position. And I'll do it manually, and you can see what happens. You can see the light rays going from the left over to the right. So I'm going to go to the beginning, and I'm going to add a keyframe on the center property of the zoom blur. And I'm going to set the center value to be roughly minus 2000. And then I'm going to jump ahead 16 frames, because that's the timing that I already determined it to be. I'm going to add another keyframe, and I'm just going to take off the minus sign, and it should flip over to the left-hand side. There we go. So if I play that back, that's close to the effect that we want. However, the blur is a bit too opaque, so we need to make some adjustments there. First, I'm going to zoom into my timeline. I'm going to make sure I'm at the beginning, and I'm going to add a keyframe to the mix property in the zoom blur. And I'm going to set that to 0. And then I'm going to move over 4 frames. I'm going to add another keyframe, and I'm going to set it to 20. And I'm going to jump to the end by clicking on the right arrow of the center property, just to get me over to that last keyframe. And I'm going to go back 4 frames. I'm going to add another keyframe to the mix property at that position. I'm going to leave it at 20. And then I'm going to go back to the end again. I'm going to add a 4th keyframe to the mix property and reduce that value down to 0. So the effect that that's having, it's going to fade in this blur to only a maximum of 20%, where originally you saw it at 100%. So it's not going to be anywhere near as strong. So we'll see how that looks. Well, that's pretty good. That looks a lot like what it's supposed to. One thing that I forgot to do was change the color of the Smallville logo to more of a yellowish orange or yellowish red. So one way to do that is to select the parent group, the Smallville back group. I'm going to add the Colorize filter, which can be found under Color. And I'm going to select the Remap White 2. And here I'm going to pick the color. Right about there, and maybe a little bit darker. Now that I've changed the color of the Smallville text, you can see a difference in the intensity of the zoom blur effect. Before I copy the zoom blur into all the other letters of the Smallville logo, we actually need to add one more effect, and we're going to add the bloom effect. So I'm going to select S, and under Filters, I'm going to go to Glow and Bloom. And again, these values have been predetermined based on me figuring this out ahead of time. So the amount needs to be set to 32, the brightness at 100, and the threshold at 0, and I'm going to set the mix to 5. And again, like what we did with the zoom blur, I'm adding a keyframe at the beginning in the mix property. And then I'm going to jump ahead to the very end of that 16 frame timeline, and I'm going to add another keyframe to the mix property. They're both going to stay at 5%, and then I'm going to move the playhead right to the center, which should be frame 8. I'm adding one more keyframe, and I'm going to change the value of the mix to 100. And what this is doing is it's giving us a really cool glowing effect on the letter. So the next step is to take these two filters, the zoom blur and the bloom. I'm going to select them both. I'm going to hit Command C to copy them, and I'm going to put them into each letter one at a time in the word Smallville. I'm going to paste them using Command V into the M. And then I'm going to type +7 to move them 7 frames in. I'm going to go to A and do the same thing. But here I'm going to press +14. And then I'm going to select L1. Command V to paste again. Select them both. +21. And you can see where I'm going. I'm just going to do the rest of these real quick. Okay, so I've got all of those effects copied into each letter. And I'm going to play it back. That's pretty close. One thing we need to add is a light source. I'm going to add that right now under Add Object. I'm going to choose Light. And I'm going to move that so it goes right over the Smallville text. I'm going to start it right about here, just outside. And again, like before, I've already predetermined these values. I know the position needs to be 600. And the light properties, the intensity needs to be really high at 150,000. And the fall off start can be 0 with a fall off of 60. Because I moved that light out on the Z axis, I'm going to make an adjustment to where I want it to start, right about here. And I'm going to add a keyframe at that position. And then I'm going to move this all the way over to just past the end. And I'm going to set another keyframe. And I'm going to move the light all the way across. And in the center point, I want it to go up a little higher. And if I move that, it's going to add a keyframe automatically. I think I'm going to lower the brightness of my bloom value. That was set to 100. I'm going to drop that to, say, 65. I'm going to do this for all of them real quick. Okay, so they're all changed. I'm going to play that again. Yeah, that's a lot better. Now, I realize this is not 100% the same as the TV show, simply because we're using a blur effect rather than actual light rays. We're not doing any ray tracing or anything like that. But this is pretty good. This serves the purpose. So that's the end of part one. In part two, we'll continue this, and we'll finish the effect on the Smallville text that's in the back. And in the foreground, there's actually two more versions of the Smallville logo. One is quite large, and it moves to the left and then fades out. And the other one is behind that and moves to the right and fades out. And the Smallville text that you're seeing on the screen changes its appearance as well. So come on back for part two. Thanks so much for watching. I'm John Martins. Please subscribe, and I'll see you next time on Apple A Day.